shot. All right, quiet on the set.
Okay. Just overall thoughts on going to Buffalo this weekend?
Yeah, I guess we're just excited. It's another opportunity to go back to the Frozen Four, which is something you work for all year long. So we know how hard it is to get to this point, so we're just excited to get back there and defend our national championship.
Yeah, it's a fun week. Getting there, you got a couple of nice dinners, you know, Fogo de Chao, Texas de Brazil, a couple of Brazilian steakhouses, just some perks that you don't usually get on other weekends that make this one kind of special.
Yeah, it's my first time obviously going to the Frozen Four, so this is something special, and I'm really looking forward to it. It's a good way to kick off my college career.
And obviously going from playing at the X, kind of like the home turf, and going to Buffalo, what are kind of like the pros and cons of getting far away versus playing at home?
Well, being in we get the Buffalo Sabres locker room, so that'll be kind of fun. And when we went to Chicago, we were at the one seed, so Denver got it. But that'll be nice, but we've been faring pretty well in NHL ranks, so hopefully that keeps going there.
Yeah, and I think too, just it was nice to have a lot of the fans from the state of Minnesota down at the X, so it'll be a little different dynamic, but nothing we're not used to from regionals and whatnot.
Going off that, how important and valuable is it knowing what a big fan base is going to be here in Duluth cheering you guys on?
Yeah, I think that helps anytime, you know, knowing that there's watching parties and people rooting you on, and we'll have some fans out there as well, which would be awesome. So just the support from the community has been awesome this year, last year, and I guess the year before as well, but especially going forward.
Yeah, it's really fun seeing the Snapchats, Twitter videos on Twitter, you know, everybody at the bars or watching at wherever they are. It's really cool to see, especially after we play, you know, we look at our phones, we're seeing all this stuff being sent to us. So it's really inspiring. It makes us, you know, play even harder, not just for us, but just for the whole, like, city and community as well.
Yeah, it's like in people in class, like your classmates, everybody's behind it. Everybody's getting into it. So it's just cool to see.
Now that the season's kind of wrapping up, what was it like having such a big target on your back?
kind of tiring, you know. You're getting every team's best effort, and it's just you can't take any weekends off. And I think that's something that Coach Sandlin emphasized for sure. You have a bad practice, and he's really getting honest because he knows that every team that we play is going to be at their absolute best, and that's not going to change this weekend with Providence and Denver, UMass, if we make it to that game. So. I think the entire year, just with that target on the back, it's only just prepared us even more for these next two games for sure.
Yeah, you know, like being number one, we were number one there for a while at the beginning of the year. Like, you don't want to get complacent, you don't want to get cocky, but you play with almost like a little bit of swagger. You know, teams are coming after you, and you just want to, you know, like Hilt said, you're going to get their best, so you just want to go back out and give it theirs.
And going into this weekend with the championship that you're carrying, what's the value of being able to know that you can get it done, but also, like you said, not wanting to be complacent? You have a lot of people that are maybe a little bit not hungrier for it, but who want it more just because they haven't had it yet.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of the guys, we have a lot of good, like, veteran leadership, guys that have been there before. And like you said, like, you can't be complacent, but you have to be confident in your skills that we've been there and, like, we've done that before and we've won. And teams are going to say we're hungrier, we want it more, but we want it just as bad as they do.
We know what it's like. I mean, you can say those other teams like haven't gotten yet, so they want more, but we got a taste of it last year, and it was super fun, and it was a special moment. And I think just because the guys that know that what it felt like last year, we want to feel that again even more.
We have a lot of media outlets like ESPN and stuff really asking, like, Coach Sandlin, like, how would you identify the team as a whole? What's kind of the vibe of the team or the motto? And we really haven't gotten an answer for that. So for you three, what's the team like this year?
Yeah, I think just a blue collar kind of work ethic team that has skill to back that up as well, but it all starts in the defensive zone and goes out from there. So just a blue collar team, kind of bring your lunch pail to work, and then skill builds off from there, and I think we've been pretty successful at that, as well as like a fast, simple team. So
we watch our last 10, I don't know how many games in a row, been one goal games, two goal games. I mean, that's definitely not easy on our fans or their blood pressures or their hearts, but it's kind of just the way we've been playing, and I feel like these next two games are going to be the exact same, 2-1, 3-2, just grinded out games where, you know, it's going to be a couple plays that are going to be the difference of the game, but that's just our team. I mean, I don't think we're going to go out there and absolutely kill a team 5-1, but obviously that'd be nice, but we just got to prepare for the worst.
Yeah, you know, like they said, we're a blue-collar team, obviously both defensively out. And like you said, it's going to be tight games. We have the skill guys that can convert. And so when we can get those chances, they're going to make those big plays and big times. But we're here to work and just stick with what's been working for us.
And obviously you guys are focusing on the game on Thursday more with Providence College. But how have you guys been preparing for Providence College and then hopefully UMass or Denver?
And then you just take it one day at a time. You know, with the last week, it was nice having the week off so guys can kind of rest up and get their bodies ready to go. But the biggest thing is just approaching each day with the right mindset and getting ready. You know, it's one day at a time, one day mentality. So, you know, coming up, showing up to practice with the right, you know, right mindset. And then when we get to Thursday, just worrying about that 60-minute game. And then hopefully, you know, the pieces fall into place where they're supposed to. So just, you know, one day at a time.
Yeah, it's just the task at hand. I mean, it's hard. You want to look forward to the final game, but you show up every day and you got to do what needs to be done just to make yourself better, make your teammates better, and obviously you don't look too far ahead. You just focus on that next game.
And we played Denver 2-4 times, split with them, so we kind of know what they're like. We haven't seen UMass, but we just watched them on the TV a couple of those games, and they've been number one team in the country for most of the year too. So you got to respect that we have. But yeah, like we said, we're focusing on Providence right now, and when the time comes, we'll shift our focuses to one of those two other teams.
And Peter, you're one of only three seniors this year. It's the smallest senior class on the roster since 1961. What is the dynamic like for you as a senior and then for y'all just being on the team as well with such a small class?
Yeah, it's a little different because especially my first year here, we had a older team with a lot of seniors and whatnot. And then especially for me being a transfer, so I wasn't, I guess, here for four full years. But it's just a little bit different. We had a younger team last year as well. So it's just, you know, we have younger guys that have experience though. So you know, you can look into it, I guess, if you want. But I think the biggest thing is just we want to go out on you know, the same note as we did last year. And we have the experience and, you know, maybe not the age or, you know, as some other teams do. But we have the experience, and that I think that's big for this time of year.
Yeah, Parker and Billy. You know, Parker's old guy. Pete's an old guy. Billy's a good leader. And then even our sophomore and junior class, I mean, the three Frozen Fours in a row, two Frozen Fours in a row for those guys. So we got guys with 80 to 120 games that aren't considered old guys, but they definitely have a lot of experience. So just not to identify the guys as classes, but just as the amount of experience we have is different than I think other teams have.
And so far there's been 13 Bulldog hockey alumni that have played in the NHL this season. Have you guys been reaching out to them or had them reaching out to you, giving, you know, support or advice? And what's that been like?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, you get to keep in touch with some of the older guys. And we're fortunate enough to live with one of the guys whose brother has made his debut this year. And just it's a cool experience getting to see the guys you played with, you were at the rink with, you know, every day last year, the year before it, get their chance to you know, live out their childhood dream. And it's pretty sweet to be able to see that. And, you know, hopefully one day that's, you know, everyone else's goal as well. So,
yeah. Another special thing about the program is how many guys come back in the summer to visit or work out. So that's really nice, is all those guys that are making the next step to the next level. Are always coming back, you know, giving back to the program, visiting with us, giving us tips, you know, helping us grow as people as well, so that for one day maybe we can kind of follow in their footsteps. So that's really nice as well.
Yeah, and I've been pretty lucky just my first year here, getting thrown into the mix. I've been lucky enough to meet a handful of those guys, and it's something special because, you know, that's how the culture is here. It's they expect that out of guys now, like to move on to the next level. So being able to meet those guys is pretty special.
And looking back at this season, what were some of the biggest challenges the team had to overcome? And in retrospect, you know, how did all of that work out?
I think, yeah, like you said, having the target on your back, you know, defending a national championship and knowing that we're going to come in and not be complacent is something that's difficult. You read the polls or, you know, guys can kind of get caught up in this or that. And I think we've done a good job of not letting that creep in this year, which is not easy to do. So, you know, that we're going to get everyone's best. It's but that's a challenge that we've wanted to welcome all year long. So I think just, you know, like I said, the right mindset throughout the whole year and knowing that it's going to be a challenge and a grind, but it's going to be worth it in the end and to get to this time of year and we're playing now still.
Yeah, I think after we went on that, 8-game win streak, you know, we kind of had a bit of a lull in the season there. I don't know if we thought that it was going to be easy, but it was kind of a little up and down, kind of rocky road after that. And I feel like that was kind of tough on the team, tough on the coaching staff, tough on everybody. But, you know, we battled through it. We had a nice last month and a bit here, about 6-8-game win streak again. So, I mean, that's what you got to do. That's all about the tournament. You got to peak at the right time, and that's what we're doing.
Yeah, it's all just about just finding what kind of team we are, and I feel like over the course of the season, we weren't one team, but as we've been growing here now, like, we know what kind of team we are, and we found what's stuck with us, and that was just something we had to fight through all season, but getting to it now, it was definitely worth it.
And with not flying out until tomorrow, right now, Duluth is obviously very excited and ready to celebrate, and how do you guys stay focused, but also capture that energy and that excitement until you leave tomorrow?
Just got to know that if we get the job done, we get to come back and share the experience with everybody here, so you just got to focus up and realize that everybody's going to be a frenzy down here. Everybody's going to have fun, but you just take care of business and you get to come back and have fun with them too. So,
yeah, like Hild said, and you know, getting to do that the last year and the year before, and seeing all the support we had from the fans, and you just know that everyone's going to be watching somewhere, and it's pretty special. And you know, you kind of use that as motivation as well to help get you to where you want to go. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, you want to do it for the school, and you want to do it for the city. So it's just a little bit more incentive. You want to share, like you said, just share it with everybody when we come back.